Alvina here from the online counseling platform Mind Be Well. Thank you for tuning in, and let's get right into today's topic. So I know I needed this talk in the beginning of the pandemic just as a way to know there are better days to come. I had my days where work or just being alone with my thoughts wasn't helping with my overall mental health, and just being at home in a very small apartment was also not a helpful space to be in. So I had to figure out the things that worked, that I stopped, what I valued, who mattered, and just started doing things to really pick myself back up, knowing that I could change my narrative even if I started small. So with that, let's get into defining resilience and how you build it for yourself to get over those humps that life throws at you. So resilience, we know, is how we pick ourselves, you know, back up from dealing with a challenge. It's a strength that you show yourself that you will not be broken by certain circumstances that come your way. It's being able to change your perspective and adapt to your environment, accepting that things will happen, that you will not let things define you and what you're capable of. And with that, let's go into some helpful ways that I found and have researched about that help with just building the resilience in yourself, because you can do great things. I know that sounds kind of cheesy, but you can. All right, so the first thing is identifying what was meaningful and, you know, gave me purpose. So I went to school for counseling, and that is my passion. And with that not showing up for me in my daily routine in some way, since it's not something I do full time, I created this channel. I got a mentor and started creating content for interacting with clients. I rebranded my website, you know, listened to podcasts, read more on just different techniques to utilize for my clients. And I was able to just fill up my happiness bucket at the end of the day. You know, this is something that brings me joy, and it was a missing piece that I had to find ways to incorporate back into my routine. I was able to find a way to push myself more, even on challenging days, because I got back to a part of my life that I wasn't making some time for. So with that, you need to ask yourself this: how do I want to live my life? How do I want to treat others? And how do I want to be remembered? And create that little by little. The next thing is I connected with people, and not just anyone. These were people that were pretty significant in my life, my family. So having conversations and opening up about what I was struggling with and getting a different perspective, also sharing with a coworker slash friend my challenges and getting some reassurance that I wasn't alone in my experiences, and just feeling like I, you know, couldn't get over certain humps with work or certain challenges that were happening, or certain stressors that were just occurring with work. Also having a boyfriend that just listened without judgment, and having friends that I could reconnect with virtually to really forget about what stressors were occurring, and just hearing about someone else's happiness was really good for me. Because I don't know if you've ever heard, I think when you're struggling with something, either being able to help someone or just kind of being a listening ear for others can really just help you feel like you're doing something instead of focusing on your own challenges and what's not working. All right, so the next thing, I made meditation a habit for real. All right, so every morning, Tamara Lovett from Calm, I know I talk about the Calm app a lot, but she got me right. She gave me a daily intention that was the push that I needed, and continuing meditation made some of the daily challenges I was having minute. Because I was stressing about what I wanted others to change instead of me adapting. I started to choose to not let the same type of behaviors from others impact me. My mindset was a little calmer. I let things go a bit easier, especially those things I couldn't control. I allowed those daily meditations to serve as reminders on how I should carry out the day. So find something that you can at least push to do on a regular basis that helps you take your mind off of things. So last, I started to create some healthier thoughts. If I could be intentional about meditation, I could be intentional about creating new thoughts, especially when it's very easy for certain negative thoughts to arise. I focused on how things could be looked at from a different perspective. I took moments to recreate, you know, certain thoughts into healthier ones, focusing on what I could do in this moment, how I wanted to be a calmer version of myself in this moment. And it helped me remember my earlier meditation message, which allowed me to get out of my head and push through a tough day of either just having too much work to do, not knowing where to start, being stuck at home and not being able to go anywhere. But really those were some of the things that have helped me as I was kind of just dealing with my own challenges, helped build resilience in me. And I think this could be helpful if you're dealing with stressors, burned out with anything, any areas of your life. I think being able to kind of go back to some of these things. Please leave a comment if you found this helpful. But thank you for tuning in, and I will talk with you later.